Good evening, everybody. Welcome back to the Magic Beans stream. Back again tonight with Shorty with, I think it's fair to say, my favorite type of deck, mono red burn, or just mono red aggro, anything mono red. I'm all about that. As Pedro in the chat has said, that is a list he can get behind. Pedro, loved your quote for the finals recently, the live by the mountain, die by the mountain. 100% get behind that. So that's what we're doing tonight. We are jamming red spells and small red creatures and throwing burn at people's faces. So let's have a look at the list. This is what we've got. Yeah, this is a budget list off MTG Goldfish that was a burn list, and the initial budget list was playing like no rares at all, which is pretty impressive that you can play a deck in standard and not have any rares. So it was running like the O3 wall, whatever that's called, that pings whenever you cast an instant or sorcery, you tap it to deals one and then it untaps when you cast an instant or sorcery, and yeah, just more burn, but no Chandras, no Reckless Stormseekers, that sort of thing. So yeah, I like to have a look at the MTG Goldfish budget list, because he always posts, like Seth, Saffron Olive, always posts down the bottom a non-budget version, and they're usually the ones that are worthwhile looking at. It's like, okay, what are the small upgrades that we can do to this list to actually make it competitive? And he didn't have much added to the list when he did it. I think he just added a couple of Chandras and that was kind of it. So I took that list and have been tinkering with it over the last couple of weeks, and this is sort of where I've landed. So we'll run you through that in a sec. I've been doing fairly well. I was in like, I don't know, gold 2 or something like that, and it very quickly took me through gold and into platinum, and I've been floating up and down in platinum with this list. So I'm currently like, I think halfway through plat 3, something like that. We've got some standard, the classic mono red stuff that we've been seeing for a while in standard. So Commander Faces Karkazan. This card is just bonkers. Like, it is just, it's just everything that you want out of a one mana red card. And the thing that I didn't even realize until people started playing Liliana is the first chapter deals one damage to each planeswalker they control as well. So it's actually really good at just picking off Lilianas that have come down and tick down to make you sacrifice a creature. So that's quite good. But we know this card. It's doing everything you want. Phoenix Chick has been really solid. I don't think I've ever actually bought it back from the graveyard, but being able to go turn one Kamanu into turn two Phoenix Chick, get a counter, and just start chipping in. Like, people just don't want to kill it because they think that you're going to bring it back from the graveyard. So it performs really well. Play with Fire, fantastic. We want burn in the main deck of this list. We want burn that can go to the face. So playing Play with Fire works really well. This card has been surprisingly good. It just gets in for damage all the time. And the fact that it's in your hand a lot is really good. Like, you can play it on turn one. Yeah, it comes back to your hand. You play it on turn two. The amount of times I've gone turn one, Reinforce Ronin, bounce it back to my hand. Turn two, Reinforce Ronin, bash them. Like, they've already taken 6 on turn two. And you've got nothing on the board, which sounds bad. You know, you want to be building a board presence, but they also can't kill it when it's not on the board. And board wipes and things like that are just useless, because you've just got these hasty creatures that are just always chilling in your hand. And the amount of times that you can go, all right, I can haste this dude out, attack, get in for whatever, like get in for 2, bounce it to my hand at the end of turn, and then you've got it in your hand so you can cycle it and hopefully find a burn spell or something like that as well. It's fantastic. Yeah, and Meat Hook is the other thing. It just never dies to Meat Hook, so really good. And even like going turn one Kumanu into turn two Reinforce Ronin, it's bashing as a 3-3. Like, that's pretty solid. So very happy with that. And yeah, the channeling ability is quite useful. Just put these two in here. I was running, I can't remember what it's called, but it's similar to this Reckless Impulse card, but it has Casualty. I was running that and I've moved away from it because I found I was just never casting them. And this I'm finding is much better. Probably should be playing 4 of these, but I'm actually using it more as a 5-drop. Like, it's handy to have a 2-mana 2/2 haste. You know, we've seen that before. Like, someone in chat will remind me. But yeah, casting this on 5 is really good. You know, you get a 3-3 with haste, and you get to cast Robber the Rich. There we go. Thanks, Pedro. Knew you'd be on it. Being able to cast your burn spells out of the graveyard as well is just, again, it's just exactly what you want to do. It just gives you that little bit of reach at the end of the game to sort of finish things off. This card has massively overperformed. The fact that it's whenever you cast a non-creature spell, it's not just instant and sorcery, is amazing, because it triggers off of Kumanu, it triggers off of Chandra, as well as obviously all your other instants and sorceries, but everything is just triggering this thing, and it very quickly adds up to 4, 5, 6 damage over a game when you've just got one, and if you've got two of them out there, it just gets nasty. The other thing that I found is really good is going turn one Kumanu, turn two Kessig Flamebreather, because this comes in as a 2/4. So if you're on the play, you know, you play turn one Kumanu, your opponent goes turn one Swamp, pass the turn, they're expecting that they can cut down whatever you're casting as your 2-drop. But they can't, because it becomes a 2/4 and cut down doesn't work anymore. And so then they're having to pay 2 mana for like Infernal Grasp, and they're copping the life loss as well. So it's fine. Like, you're more than happy to make that trade. So this coming in as a 2/4, like, it's a great blocker. It blocks Boxer Dude that comes out of your graveyard, the 3/2, and then the red-black, you know what I'm talking about. Once all the black decks are playing. Blocks them. So, yeah, fantastic. Lightning Strike, yep, straight up burn. So glad to have this back in Standard. This card is awesome. I didn't even know this card existed. Tenacious Underdog, yep, that's the one. What's the red-black one? Reckless Impulse. Even just playing this on turn two, if you've got nothing desperate that you need to be playing on turn two, you know, you don't need to be committing to the board with creatures or anything like that. Bloodtithe Harvester, got there. Just playing it on turn two, because it's exile, it's basically like Light Up the Stage. Obviously, it costs more, but Light Up the Stage has the 3-mana option, the 1-mana option. This is right in the middle. It's until the end of your next turn you may play those cards, so you do the, well, ideally, you know, you play it on turn three, and you, before you play a land, you play Reckless Impulse, and hopefully you hit a land, and you hit a 1-drop, or whatever, and then you've almost always got a 1-drop you can play out of your hand, play a land out of your hand, whatever, and get the value, and then you've got till the end of your next turn to cast as well. So this card's been awesome, and obviously triggers your Kessig Flamebreather. Call in a professional. Gee, it hurts to be paying 3 mana for a Lightning Bolt. But the other two things on this actually come up a lot. First line, players can't gain life this turn. Comes up a lot. The amount of times you can just shoot them for 3, you know, I've seen a few Angels decks, I've seen a few green-white enchantments decks that are gaining a bunch of life. Even Shieldred, you know, in their upkeep, they get their Shieldred trigger, or their draw set, whatever, Shieldred trigger, you can burn them for 3, and you cancel the 2 life that they're going to gain. Works quite well. Same with Meathook Masker. Yeah, that comes up a lot. The damage can't be prevented this turn. I didn't even tweak it, like, literally says it on the card. Shield counters don't prevent this damage as they're removed, so you're removing a shield counter to prevent the damage that would destroy the creature, but the damage can't be prevented. So actually works quite well for finishing off creatures with shield counters. Other than that, hasn't seemed to have come up, but yeah, just 3 mana, instant speed, usually going to the face is kind of what we want in this list. So been pretty happy with that. Would much prefer if it was 2 mana. Or 1 for Lightning Bolt would be even better. Reckless Stormseeker, we've seen this one heaps of times. It's just, again, it's just doing exactly what you want in this deck. Does come up quite a bit that you play this and you just give the +1/+0 to your Phoenix Chick instead and just get through in the air with a bit of extra damage. Chandra Dress to Kill, could definitely see this as a 4 of. It's kind of occupying a similar slot to Bloodthirsty Adversary, a Bloodthirsty Adversary. The amount of time, like, the most common line of play I'm seeing with this is play it on turn 3, +1, add a red. So again, if you've got a Kessig Flamebreather, you know, you've gone turn 1, Kumanu, turn 2, Kessig, turn 3, Chandra, you're pinging them for 1 off the Kessig, pinging them for 1 off the Chandra, and then hopefully you're playing, you know, a Phoenix Chick or a Reinforced Ronin or something like that, and so then you're getting in with the extra damage as well. So yeah, works really well. I've managed to -7 at once, which is always fun. That's certainly a game ender. And then when you've just got nothing else to do, you spend a lot of your turns going, okay, if I add the red mana from Chandra, can I maximize that mana, or do I want to see what I find and cast the card? You know, if you're already on 4 or 5 lands, you probably want to be plussing it next on the top card of your library, so that way if it's a land, it's gone. If it's not, then it's a card you can cast. So works well. 20 lands, we're playing best of 1, so we can easily play 20. I mean, we could probably cheat the system and play 19. Our curve is pretty low, but 20 is pretty good, and yeah, a couple of Sakensans just to have some utilities in our land. Gee, I would love it if we had Den of the Bugbear. Just, yeah, it would be so good. Running more creatures, less burn. Yeah, like, there's the, you know, the Thundering Raijus, and there's a bunch of other good hasty creatures. I've just found the burn version, like this version, the Kessig Flamebreather just puts you in a spot where it's like, okay, like Mono Red happens a lot where you just can't attack. You know, they get up some creatures, whatever. It's like, well, I just have no good attacks. I'm just doing nothing. And Kessig Flamebreather just gives you reach. You know, you can every time you cast a call in a professional, that's 4 damage. Like, that is a lot. And if you draw multiples, you can just kind of sit behind your walls and just burn their face out. So that's very nice. Hammerhand. Enchantment enters the battlefield. Target creature can't block this turn because +1/+1 has haste. Yeah. I think instead of playing this, like, yes, the target creature can't block is nice. I would actually probably rather play Rabbit Battery because it's a 1/1 hasty dude on its own. And you don't run into the issue that you always have with enchantments where they kill your creature and you're 2-for-1-ing sort of thing. So this thing drops off. You still have a 1/1 haste. So it's kind of removal proof a little bit. The other card that was a possibility is Electrostatic Infantry. But I've just found, like, this is a dude you want to be attacking with. And as just a 2-mana 1/2, it's not that good. And yes, I'm playing a fair amount of instants and sorceries, but getting it up, like, you really need it to be like a 3/4, and it doesn't have haste, so it just didn't feel right. So I ended up haven't stuck with those. Hammerhand Radda's Firebrand is good. Yeah, Radda's Firebrand's another one. I'm also conscious of not burning a ton of wild cards on a deck that may not be very good, but yeah, this card's decent. But again, it doesn't have haste. I mean, looking at our list, the only creature that doesn't have haste is the Kessig Flamebreather, which we don't really have in our deck to be attacking. It's there for the sort of the chip damage that piles up over time. So red for X increase. Oh, so a couple other cards are considering. So yeah, there's the Defiler, which I don't think I'll play because it is 4 mana. Again, doesn't have haste, but does, it's triggering off red permanent spells, which we aren't casting a lot of. So it's the opposite of your Kessig Flamebreather. There's Squee, which is not bad, but I don't think 3-mana 2/2, we get a 1/1. It's not bad. I can definitely see a couple of Squees. Don't know what I would play or what I would take out for that, because it's just increasing my curve a bit. I think the Stormseeker is just better, especially if you can get this on the knight side. And then the other one is the Dragon, Shivan Devastator. That's it. Yeah, I've seen a few people playing this, and I think I want to try this. It's just a way to close out the game out of nowhere. You know, you get stuck in top deck mode, you got your opponent down to 5 or something like that, you're just drawing a bunch of lands, this thing just ends the game out of nowhere. So I think I'd like to fit this in as a 2-of. I don't know what I'm taking out for it. Like, it would probably have to be the adversaries, because they're occupying sort of a similar slot where I'm really playing them as a 5-drop, and I probably really want to be playing this as a 5-drop. I would like to fit this in my list. I just don't know what I'm taking out for. Maybe, you know, one of these is a sideboard card, but we'll run this for now. We'll see how it goes. Okay, so yeah, this is what we want to see. We want to see Kamanu into Kessig, and then go from there. So happy with that hand. These guys have just been really good, because you don't need to be playing them early. You just pop in for that 2 damage out of nowhere. And then once you've done it once, your opponent just has to respect it. They just know you've got it all the time. Alright, so what do we got on the other side? We've got probably the red-white heroic-y style deck. Plunksy's got some exciting news. Olive walked 5 steps today. Wow, Plunksy. That's pretty cool. Yeah, so I think we just kill this thing. Or we could actually double. A double Ronin. Maybe we attack in and see if they've got some sort of pump spell for this initiate. We might be able to pick it off. Yeah, well, we'll leave up their mana and try and kill whatever they cast. Adeline. So I'm going to kill this initiate first. Okay. We might just go double Phoenix Chicks here and just start attacking over the top. Getting aggressive. Yeah, once they start walking, it's pretty scary. G'day, Chew. What's the temperature currently where you are, Chewy? What would be, what, like 7:30 for you? I imagine it'd be about 26, 27 maybe, something like that. All right, Thalia's nasty, and Adeline's starting to get big, but we're... Land would be fantastic about three turns ago, but we can just keep swinging in over the air. Unfortunately, Adeline having vigilance is annoying. 27 right now, there we go. I don't care too much about wedding announcement at the moment. I mean, I'm fine to just block this token. I'm just going to keep flying over in the air. I've got no life gain at the moment. Alright, we've got another land. So we can play this dude, put the plus one on our Phoenix. Just get in for some more. We have a nice clock. Alright, I'm going to now a gun jaw. So we may... We may haste in a Ronin here, so we can attack and trigger. We can attack and trigger our Phoenix chick. And this thing's on nighttime now, so now we can give plus two to something. So we actually have two, three, four. So we've got lethal in the air. Yeah, we could attack with something else, but these Ronins are kind of doing not a great deal at the moment. So we pump this, attack one, two, three, trigger the Phoenix chick. Oh, Emperor, okay, well, that keeps him alive. Exiles my dude too. And we're down to seven, so... We have lethal on board. But yeah, we're just chumping. Just chumping dudes here. So we chump. 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 Doesn't have trample, does it? No. Yeah, okay, that works. Because that would be one from the Kumanu, one from the Flame Breather, and then we've got, yeah, birds coming in, phoenixes. So, solid start. Yeah, fine with this. We can go turn one Kumanu, turn two we play the Phoenix chick first, put the counter on that, then play Reinforced Ronin, happy with that. Home Sunday, weren't you coming? You were coming home Sunday... Anyway, weren't you? Yeah, Debrune won the last one we got there. Single blue. So there's no... I don't believe, someone correct me if I'm wrong, but there's no single blue counter of a creature spell. There's... spell pierce, but I don't care too much about that. Not at the moment. Fading Hope? Okay, that's fine. I don't mind if you Fading Hope my Hasty Dudes. Yeah, it's Rona's Vortex and Fading Hope. We do see a bit of that. No land. So they've got the Make Disappear. Cannot unless I pay one. So I'll probably play the Phoenix Chick first because I want that to stick around for a little bit. But that was the very first time I've returned a Phoenix Chick from the graveyard. So this one will likely get countered. That's fine. They know about it in my hand already. Syncopate, okay. Glad I played it that way because I don't want my Phoenix Chick getting syncopated. Gee, we are rough on the lands tonight. So I'm going to hang on to the Ronin. We'll leave up this. Consider. So home Sunday. That's right. You've got your night shift stuff you got to do. That's going to be rough. Drive up Thursday. Yeah, okay. So no podcast for you next week either. Ugh, Tolarian Terror is nasty. That thing's going to be... That's going to be painful. And the Ward 1's going to be... I mean, we can kill it. Oh, it's Ward 2, that's right. I think we just ignore it for the time being. I'm just going to burn them in the face. Like, we've got... A call in a professional as well. Good night, Ryan. This is nice. We can go wide as well. But yeah, drawing a land would be fantastic. But they can't really afford to be attacking with this Tolarian Terror either. So we'll just keep getting in with chip damage and we'll get there. Kind of what we do. They're drawing bulk lands. Okay, so I would love to be casting this now, but I'm not casting this into five open. I also don't have a creature to cast. I mean, I can haste this in. I'll probably just haste this in anyway. Haste it in as a 3-3 and just attack. It's going to get countered, but it draws a counter out. Yep, that's fine. Land would be fantastic. Bounce my Phoenix Chick. Yep, okay. That's alright. We can cast it again. Yeah, Haughty Djinn. Okay. Alright, found a land. Do they have a counter spell? Is the question. I guess we find out. All right, let's see if you got it. Ah, of course they do. Okay. Yeah, so this still can't attack. Alright, one card in hand, so now Reckless Impulse. Things... Oh, man, where are our lands? Alright, We'll get to Scry. We'll cast this and Scry in their turn. If they want to counter something. Nope. Okay, there's a land. Do we want that land, though? They had no counter for this. Didn't even give them an option. So unless they've got an Essence Scatter, which they can play, the Hordijin does give them a discount. So I think we actually just bottom that. Maybe we want lands just to set ourselves up for future turns. Yeah, we'll keep the land. So we can play Flame Breather, probably sets us up better to win off of one spell. We could, or we can just play back to back to back Stormseekers. Nah, we probably. Yeah, so if we don't draw a spell, we're just playing this, then this. Okay, getting aggressive. Interesting. I mean, we could triple block the Terror, then we just lose our. Gonna kill our Flame Breather. 4/7, so they can pump this. They've got to have something, otherwise they're not just attacking in for no reason and just leaving themselves dead on board. Otherwise, why would you do that? Unless you're just trying to bluff. Hey, Cracker. If I take it, I take 13. I'm dead to the Hordijin next turn if I don't find anything. So they may have like the pump spell, +1/+1. Yep, so kill my Flame Breather. Still is with a dude and a hasty dude. Found a counter. Bounce something. March. Eesh. Okay. Okay. They've had enough. Alright. Yeah, so if we draw land there, we play the Bloodthirsty Dude and Flashbacker spell. If they counter the Bloodthirsty Dude, we still have 3 mana left to cast the other Hasty Dude, so in a pretty good position either way. Yeah, this looks fine. We can keep that. Finish my cup of tea. I did. Hack leader. Okay. I don't need to kill this yet. I think we get some damage on the board first and keep. Man, we've just got bulk burn here. If we could draw a third land, it would be fantastic. Let's just get some recursive damage on the board first. Yeah, no blocks is. Yeah, they had 3 cards in hand. You don't attack in with your dudes when your opponent's got 3 creatures with nothing. And they had the march as well, so they were either swinging in just to go, oh, I'm dead anyway. Double, send a pack. Let's see how these things work again. Gets a +1 counter if you have that. When you cast them out of spell. Alright, so they're not getting bigger just yet. But we can play another Phoenix Tuke and leave up our Play with Fire. Uh, 20 land, and it has not been a problem. And I mean, not hitting 3 mana on curve is not the end of the world in this deck, like the curve is so low. I think we just play with fire and burn their face here. We're just going to string these together. See if you give me another target. Shigeki. Turn it to its owner's hand, reveal the top four cards, you don't put the land card from them onto the battlefield. Right. Interesting. Alright, so let's get the scry on. Do we want another Phoenix Chick? Kind of messes with our plan. We're just wasting a turn if we play it. Another Phoenix Chick is nice, but I think we just bottom it. If we didn't have a handful of three drops. I guess the question is, do we want to kill this thing? Top four cards, even put a land card. So it's just ramp. And it's bouncing it to their hand. And they're filling their graveyard. I'm interested to see what this thing's doing. They are playing green-black. I've not seen a green-black deck. I think we're just burning them to the face. They are piling on the damage here. It's not a sorcery speed thing. It's cool art on that. Gala Greeters. Now, I went ever another creature. Okay, that's fine. So we could, if they play another creature here, yeah, so we just, this thing, this Quirion Beast Caller can get out of hand, but we burn them now, because that prevents any life, although we could have, probably should have waited till they chose their mode. Okay, they still chose the life gain mode because they didn't read calling a professional. Now we're flooding out, which is not ideal. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if they play a creature, this thing can get bigger, this thing gets bigger. So they do have lethal, potentially. But we can kill something instead of going to the face. These things can't block, so makes my choices obvious. A bit cold out there. So we can let that resolve. Let's just create a treasure token. So they've gone for the gain 2 life. So we're at 2, 4, 5, 6. We're at 9. Burn them for 3. They go to 5. Yeah, so if we just burn them in the face, they're just dead next turn. Unless they play another creature. We may die to another creature here. 2, 4, 5, 6, 9. So if they have another creature, we're just dead. Yep, and now we win. Ugh, John Avon. No. Now we lose. They had a fight card. What is with that? That was unexpected. Yeah, good game. All right, we die. Die to our own hubris. We could have killed the creature, but... Okay. Yeah, I think this is a fine keep. Dominguez. Can he say Javier? It's not. Red, black. All right. Old blood tithe harvester. Well, that could die in a fire. Before you untap with it. I found this deck actually piles on the damage pretty quick. It's not uncommon for turn 3 for them to be down to like 12. We just kill this. I think we just keep this board clear. If we strike it, and then we play the Ronin. Play this as a land. Yeah, turn 3, we've got them down to 13. We've had to use 2 of our burn spells on creatures. Like, that's pretty good in standard for mono red. Alright, so we Reckless Impulse first. I'd like to find a burn spell for this thing. And if we don't find one, if we don't find, like, land or play with fire or something. Not a burn spell. We've got a land, though. That's nice. I'm going to save this, and we'll just play this one out. We can cast this next turn. Save this for turn 5. We're on 4 mana already. If we can get a lightning strike off of it, is pretty good. If you want to chump block my Ronin with your treasure goblin, that's fine by me. Yeah, these guys just overform. I really need to get the altar hut on these, because it looks sweet. Pray there's no Shieldred. Yeah, Shieldred on turn 4 is nasty. They got the treasure, so we may see that. Sorin's not much better. Okay, so we've got the fifth land. So, we can adversary, lightning strike, kill this thing, kill Sorin. We lose the Stormseeker, but that's fine. Our other option is we Stormseeker and Ronin, but then they're going to gain the life off of the vampire, which is... It's only 2, but it does add up. So I think we're better off. Yeah, we do have a lightning strike in here, don't we? Yep. This thing will be a 3-3, so we can punch him in the face for 3 as well. So we play lightning strike. Cast it, kill this thing. And then we attack them with the adversary. And these two... Attack Sorin, get that out of here. And now we're in a good spot, because we've got Hasty Dude and a burn spell. 2 flyers. Even a Shieldred here is not bad. Speak of the devil. Ooh, and a Kamanu. Okay, so we should be able to kill them here. Hey, Insanity. Oh, Azzy G with the gifting subs. And a follow from Sass New Zealand. Jeez, getting off tonight. Okay, so we've got access to 5 mana. two in the air, one from this, three from this. GG's. There's nothing else they can do. They've got no untapped mana. They've got nothing. So... good game. All right. Okay, so this is one of those interesting hands where... actually, probably don't... we're on the play. I think turn one, I play the Reinforced Ronin, bash for two, and then turn two, I go double Kamanu and set up for whatever I'm going to cast on turn three to get double triggers. Ideally, not this dude, because yes, we get to attack for four, but... we're sort of wasting the counter. So I'm hoping by then we find something useful. Yeah, you got a few months to figure it out. How long does it take you to get there? Because it's in... You're south of Sydney. And the place is... where the event is also south of Sydney. Obviously it's in Sydney, but it's the bottom of Sydney. How long would it actually take you to get there? An hour. Royce, I drive an hour and a half each way for work every day. An hour and 10 is nothing. Not to mention the other 5 hours that I'm in the car every day. Just bulk driving in my world. Ooh, we got a rabbit battery version. I have seen a few rabbit battery versions getting around. They're playing the the Thundering Raijus and that sort of stuff as well. Alright, so we haven't found something yet for our double Kamanu turn, but I think that's still the line we go. Oh yeah. I mean, the place that we're staying is still 10 or 15 minutes away, so Chris is planning on hiring a car. Ooh, red-green, okay. Interesting. I'm going to hold up a burn spell for whatever I'm going to cast. Fourth land. So do we just... maybe we just play adversary, make that a 4-4, because they're likely going to have lightning strike here. But they're not going to get a chance to lightning strike my adversary, and I don't care if you lightning strike my Reinforced Ronin. 2 hours 45 by train. Ugh, that sounds horrible. Keeps a Kenzen in her hand. So yeah, let's play this. Because that's going to be a 4-4. You don't get a chance to respond, but it just comes in with the extra counters on it. So if you want to lightning strike my Reinforced Ronin, I am fine with that. Having a good think about it. It's definitely what they've got in hand. Play with fire, okay. I mean, this is what I was talking about earlier. That's turn three, and they're down to 12. And they've killed one of my creatures. That's pretty good for mono red in standard. And it just puts the pressure on a lot of decks. And then when you've got that little bit of reach with the Kessig Flame... Flame Breathers, where you don't necessarily need to be attacking, and then, you know, burn to the face. It's, you can finish games off. 2 hours 20. Well, that still sounds horrible. Speak of the devil. Man, Kamanu's just such a good card. How much removal do you have for my Kamanus? Uh, All right, so we haste this dude in. See if you want to use a burn spell. What, Plunksy, what you and Roy should do, we'll see what Cracker and Chewy say about this if they're still listening, but you should definitely do what we did, Chewy and Cracker and I, the first Sydney GP we went to, whatever that was, a few years ago. We stayed in a place. See, they're down to three, like, so good. I'm going to play this as land. Do I? Or maybe if I draw a land, I want that as some haste dudes. Yeah, maybe I'll hang on to that, actually. So we stayed in a basically a backpackers above a pub or something. And it was cheap. It was like $100 a night. Okay, Reckless Impulse is nice. Here we go. I don't consider writing an all. Okay, so this is another hand where we probably don't play Kamanu on turn two. We can hold up, play with fire. If they do nothing, we just shoot them in the face and we get the scry. And then we figure it out from there. Like, if we knew we had a creature on top, at one or a two drop, then yeah, 100% play this on turn one. But you really want to get all... I mean, it is just extra gravy if you get all of it, but bunch of burn into a Chandra. I think we hang on to this. So then the next year when we went to Sydney, that was when Poliwhuffle got involved, and he said, oh no, it's all right, don't worry about it, guys, I'll book a room. It's like, all right, cool, you know, no worries, just let us know how much we owe you, which he didn't tell us. And he Airbnb'd an apartment. I'm going to leave that on top, actually. I think we want the third land. Yeah, Airbnb'd an apartment. And I'm just going to hang on to this. I'm just going to keep burning them in the face. Getting this on the field and getting the 2-2 would be nice, but... yeah, so this apartment that Poliwhuffle rented was... insane, like on the harbour, on Sydney Harbour. It had the end of the apartment was a like 180 degree curved, like the living dining kitchen area just had a round 180 degree view of the harbour. It was nuts. It was a substantial step up from our previous year. I didn't pay enough attention to if Arena gave them a chance to respond. So I have a feeling we're going to run our Chandra into nothing here. So I'm inclined. I'm inclined to just play both commanders. Chandra will be nice. If Chandra resolves, we can play one Kamano. Didn't look like they had anything? Okay. I'm going off you, Plunksy. If they counter this, I'm going to be very annoyed. No. Okay, cool. Good job, Plunks. Paying attention. So we ping them for one. And we play a Kamanu. So they've got something. They got a Rona's Vortex. Just they needed a target. I'm going to bounce it. Yep, there it is. That's fine. Cracker, you are still there. How enjoyable was that first place we stayed at in Sydney? I mean, the odds of resolving our Chandra again is pretty slim. We don't have a creature. We're just drawing the burn half of our deck. That's fine. It was, yes, it was much better for you than it was for us. So, all right, so we've got Esper. We've tapped out a blue mana. Well, that's interesting. But they do have something. So they have a cut down. So we probably just attack, see what they do here. I'm going to cut it down. Okay. That's fine. So I'm going to fire off. Maybe we want the scry off of that. No, we're not under any pressure at the moment, so I think we just take the three while we can. Raffine, okay. We may be in trouble here, because this thing can get out of hand. It's got four toughness, and it's got ward. It's quite hard for us to kill. And they start sculpting their hand a little. So we play Kamano, we hold up this. If we can string together enough burn, we can just ignore what they're doing. The creatures are going to get bigger thanks to wedding announcement. Yeah, might as well attack now. Yeah, we can't even double spell to kill Raffine, which is annoying. The ward one just sure stacks up when you're trying to cast two spells. Ah, so we'll fire this off in their turn. Got them to six. Okay. So we're probably just going to channel this. We could find a Phoenix would be nice. We can Phoenix and play with her, not a land. That's not really what we want. I think in the sideboard of this, I think you actually probably play... probably play Fables. I reckon the sideboard you go... What tends to happen a lot, actually, in mono red lists is you go... You just go a bit bigger. So I would actually be inclined to side a couple of mountains. But yeah, we may be in trouble here. I think in best of three, you probably need to be playing 21 lands and then probably play a mountain or something. We're going to get our face punched in here. This is going to hurt. A lot. That is a lot of conniving. So much selection. Probably should have fired off this play with fire before they connived. Not looking good for us this game. Is that actually lethal? 6, 12, no, it's 16. But yeah. I don't have anything that can deal 4 damage. I could hit the Reckless Impulse. Ooh. Can play that for 5. Can flashback a call in a professional. And we get this dude. I think we leave this on top. All right. Can we fluke this? Surely you've got a counter spell or a removal spell. We just sculpted the hell out of your hand. There we go. I can't pay two twice, so sure. All right. They had it. Okay. Just short. We're on the play. We don't have a two-drop creature. I mean, we're still keeping this hand. We may just miss out on chapter two. There was a line there to win. It just... There we go. That'll do. They just had an answer. So... And a very large board. Yeah, we lose the counter, but that's fine. We got in for an extra damage. Jund. Okay. Cruelty of Gix. I haven't seen much Jund kicking around. When it attacks, exile target card. Interesting. Right, we hit our land. So I think we're going to Stormseeker here. Give itself trample. Attack. Alright, so you block, so it means you get nowhere to put your counter from your teachings. It's good. Is this the Windgrace deck? That card's nasty. I've only played against it once. Hanging on to this is nice. They pass a turn, so we've now got this dude being big. I'm going to spread. Just in case they've got some sort of removal. Alright, they're on 6. We've got 9 mana of Burnsville. So I think we want to keep up... I think we play this as a land. Just in case they do some sort of shenanigans and try and gain a bunch of life. We can prevent that. And then... we untap and we burn their face. There it is, Windgrace. When it enters the battlefield or attacks you, may put a land card from your graveyard onto the battlefield under your control, so you can discard a land card and gain 3 life. So they bring back this thing. Yep. That's fine. So they're not actually... Okay, so they're gaining life off of that. So let's just prevent that life gain. They're totally dead. I mean, it's like, how would you like to die? Let's just... I mean, Arena makes me scry. Even though they're dead, but you gotta resolve the spell. And we're on 20. This is what we want. We go turn 1 Commander, turn 2 Kessig. Hopefully we hit a land and we go turn 3 Chandra. Use the mana off of that to play either Phoenix Chick or Ronin. Seems good. Just got to hit that third land. Single blue. So we're going to get our... I'm going to get our Kessig bounced here. Probably. Hamburger Beach to a cracker, and he's got a correct link. I don't know what that gibberish was that you posted up. Thanks, Hamburger. I think we're going to get Fading Hoped here. Nope, consider. Okay, that's fine by me. You can consider. Yeah, AO's been solid. I mean, this thing just needs to die in a fire. We've got our third land, so that's fantastic. We don't have a way to kill this thing currently, but we will play that. We will play Chandra. We'll ping them for one. We'll ping them for another one off of Chandra. This. I'm going to play the Ronin here. It just represents more damage this turn. And again, this is turn 3. They're down to 11. That's pretty good in standard for mono red. Sure, take one off my Chandra. Don't care. You don't get to draw the card. That's fine by me. Oh, and a Reckless Impulse off the top two. Okay, so we Impulse first. Ping for one. See what we hit. We want to know if we want to use the mana from Chandra, which we do. So we can play the land, play the mana, play plus one Chandra. We can play Reckless Stormseeker. Plus that. Oops, got to ping you. Don't target myself with that. Is this just game? No, it's not game. No, they do have three untapped mana. Pay attention to that. But yeah, we've got ample ways to deal excess damage to them. If I'm gonna keep attacking my Chandra, that's fine. Three, four, five. So we probably plus, so we can ping for one, cast that. It's two. I think there's a bunch of ways we can do this. I'm gonna do this. Okay, lightning struck. Seems good. Yeah. Oh man, this deck is fun. This is fun. And this is one of those hands, we're on the draw. I mean, if they play a one drop, we can pick it off with this. And we're probably just playing this on turn two. But yeah, you get to cast until the end of your next turn. So it's quite nice. We do have the three mana for this. I think we keep. This may come back to bite us. We are on the draw. It's not ideal for red. Okay, you can just give us a target for our play with fire. Yeah, 10, 15 minutes from the venue, but no idea where. I think we just take. Excuse me. We just take the two, see if they play a Tenacious Underdog. Just another one of those dudes. Okay, we'll kill the other one then. They got a cut down. Alright, Chandra's nice. But yeah, I think we're just Reckless Impulsing. Set up what we want to do next turn. 2Ks down the road, okay. Tournament's Marrickville Town Hall or something. Okay. Third land. So we probably. We can Chandra and Ronin, and the Ronin comes back to our hand, which is nice. We can survive without firing this off. I think Chandra is much more valuable for us. Plus that. That's the other good thing of this. Whoop. Don't target myself. Yeah, you play this thing off of the Reckless Impulse, and then it comes back to your hand. You gonna cut down my Reinforced Ronin? Sure, that's fine by me. Ooh, okay. All right, so we have lost this game. Because they are on 19. And I mean, unless they are foolish enough to block, we basically, there is no way they block here. We basically cannot win this game now. They are at way too high of a life total. And Sheoldred just adds up. Adds up real quick. Yeah, Reckless Stormseeker does die to cut down a lot. But I do find they spend a lot of their cut downs on my early dudes. Alright, we've got a Kessig, which helps, but they just get that life back so easy with Sheoldred. Yeah, this game is done. Normally not too bad against Mono Black, but you kind of need to be on the play and you need to have them down to, you know, 10 to 12 before they play a Sheoldred, otherwise you're just in trouble, and they were on 19 when they played it, so yeah, we're just going to die very, very quickly here. You know, we can burn them for 5, plus an extra 2, so we get them to 8. And then we've got nothing in our hand. We're losing 2 a turn, and they're attacking with big dudes. Well, they just make me sack this. Sack my dude. Yeah, there's just not... There's not enough spells that we can string together to combat that 2 a turn. They'll minus Liliana. Yep. Okay, so we can kill Sheoldred here. I guess it's probably about the only thing we can do. But gee, it feels rough. Reckless Susie Watts it off the top would be nice. Reckless Impulse or a Chandra. Oh, and they got Graveyard Trespasser. Yeah, the combination of Sheoldred and Graveyard Trespasser is not good. Yep, that's game. Good game. Alright, that was game 4 turns ago. We're on the play. This is one of those interesting hands where it's like, okay, do we get in for 2... I think we do. We go turn 1, get in for 2, turn 2 we can play these 2. So assuming we draw nothing else, we go turn 1, get in for 2, turn 2 we play both of these, turn 3 we're playing this, which stops it from dying to cut down. Or we go Chandra, cast a Ronin again with the Manor of Chandra. So it's a nice hand. $70 each per night. That sounds substantially cheaper than what we're going to be paying Chris for the house that we're staying in. Oh dear. It's going to be an expensive weekend. I haven't seen these sleeves for so long. Alright, we're going Kumano. Oh, I gotta play a land. Ronan. For another two. Yeah, so next turn we've got a bunch of different things we can do. We probably... Oh, we've got the trigger off Kumano, so... Ooh, play with fire. Ooh. I think we still play the Stormseeker, because it comes in as a 3-4. Comes a 4-4 with haste. Yeah, I think that's still just better. Next turn we can go Chandra, play with fire. Next turn we will have the other side of this, so we can exile that Tenacious Underdog as well. So that seems better. Just pile it on the damage. Pile it on. Block. That's fine. This card is just... seems like 2 mana, 3-2, that you can buy back from your graveyard. Like, what has happened to Magic cards? Goodness me. Fable. Okay, so we kill the Fable token. Ooh, and a land. Okay. So now we can do many, many things. So we go land, Chandra, plus Chandra, get the mana. Ping you for one. Kill your dude. Play my Seeker and my Ronin. Bash for a lot. Alright, turn 4, they are on 6. They are on 6, I have a Planeswalker and 2 creatures. And I also have 2 hasty creatures in my hand that I can cast both of, and a Planeswalker that can ping for another damage, so... Seems okay. Scrap Heap Scrounger, yeah, I forgot about that card. Just kept coming back. It's pretty epic, this song. Trespasser. Okay, that gains you some life. Well, I don't know. It doesn't, because I don't have a creature. Okay, so this can also do another one. So I think we're just rolling everything out here. Shoot you for one. Play Stormseeker. Play this dude. Yep. So we go turn. We're on the play again. We're doing pretty well of being on the play. So I think we play the Ronin, getting for two. Then we go. Actually, no. We go Phoenix Chick. Then we go double Ronin. No, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, we'll play Ronin first. Team or energy, that's right. Just spinning the wheel of the Aetherworks Marvel. Mum, have you got any idea what I'm talking about?
Spinning the wheel of what?
Talking magic gibberish. My mum's got no idea what I'm talking about. Yes, I'm playing Magic and I'm streaming.
Awesome. No idea.
Yeah, I probably should have played that Magic Chick, actually. I like this. It's like I'm down no cards, and my opponent has taken 6. Okay, so I can Reckless Impulse, cross my fingers that I draw a land, and then I can play with fire this thing. If I'd hit no lands, this thing's going to get big and become a problem. So maybe we just play it safe just to get this thing off the field. And maybe we just commit the Phoenix Chick to the field. Thanks, Plunks. I'm also not her baby boy. I am the eldest of 4 boys. Presence on the board. Yes, I have no presence on the board, but they also can't kill any of my creatures because they're all in my hand. All right, so gee, some land will be nice, but I think we still kill this thing. You can bash me for 4. I don't really mind. Maybe we just a Reckless Impulse. I hit a land. I'm getting nothing out of it, but I'm setting up for next turn like a Chandra. Yeah, I need to hit land. This is when you want to be hitting 2 lands off your Reckless Impulse. Yeah, we're just bashing for 1. This is not ideal. Pluxy, no, that's a secret. How do you remember that? Obviously, I've told that on the stream before. Goodness me. People who end the game with all their creatures in their hand tend to be the people who've lost the game. Okay. Oh, I look away for 2 seconds and suddenly they have a large board presence. I would like to cast Stewed, but I don't think I'm going to get the opportunity to, because I think I'm going to be playing... I think I play Chandra, I plus, and I Lightning Strike this Primal Adversary. But this game could slip away from us reasonably quickly, actually, with my lack of board presence. Nope. Oh, that cast that card. And this is the song that reminds me of Cyberpunk. Has anyone been watching Edgerunners? CP Edgerunners? Rolling Royce is your special. Oh yeah, this game is definitely slipping away from us. It's the Rolling Royce specialty. Yeah, Cyberpunk Edgerunners. If you have not watched it, get onto it. Himsy, what's the problem here? There's no problem here. We've got massive board presence. But yes, we are going to die. Lack of snacks? No, I've been chomping down the snack. I was saying earlier, you might have missed the start of the stream. It's good when my mum comes to visit because she brings cupcakes and brownies and stuff. Music needs an extra 10 to 20% volume. Okay. Just depends how much I talk as to how much you get to listen to the music. Yeah, we're just dying. Yeah, there's... So gross. We can't block. We literally have no blockers. We are just dead. Go for it. Who was it? Cracker said you're interested in it. Okay. It's You haven't played Cyberpunk, have you? There's a lot of... there is a lot of stuff from the game, like from the computer game. Play this and this. Draw some more lands with this. When will MTG come to Netflix? Well, there is the show. Gee, I wish that they would do their magic show like Arcane or Edgerunners or something like that, where it's just, like, it's actually gritty and edgy. I mean, Edgerunners is a bit more than gritty and edgy. It is a do not watch this show with your children. Play the chick. One of these is going to get killed by a cut down. Yes, they are making one, but it's, I guarantee you, it's going to be garbage. It's going to be, it's going to be very G-rated, not what people actually want. Okay, taking the damage. I'm going to kill it end of turn. Nope. All right. I'll take the scry. Flame breather. I do want to hit land. Don't know if this is what I actually want here. It's gonna get killed. Maybe I'll take it for the long game. I think I'm going to still Reckless Impulse this turn. Obviously, we know we're not drawing a land. So if we can hit a land off of the Reckless Impulse, and then we have Play with Fire up. I watched the first episode of Masters of the Universe and did not enjoy it. And didn't watch the rest. So... Dungeons and Dragons movie, though, that does look very cool. Like Chris Pine, that's the Chris that's in that one. He's cool. I like him. He's a good actor. He's funny. Extracting the truth from me. Reveal my hand, choose a creature, enchantment, or planeswalker card from it. Well, you can't hit my burn spell, but you can take one of my creatures. Creature, enchantment, or planeswalker. Yeah, the D&D, I mean, they've done D&D movies in the past and they've been atrocious, but this one actually looks legit. They've got good actors, it looks cool, and they're doing the correct thing by actually putting proper comedy into it. We don't want that. So I think we Reckless Impulse again. See if we hit more lands. Our opponents missed a land drop. Good. Right, and we'll play one of these Commandos rather than the Phoenix Chick, because then we can get counter on the Phoenix Chick next turn. But yeah, the D&D movie looks cool. You took Massacre. Ouch. Okay, so we just Commando, Phoenix Chick. Next turn we get to attack with only two creatures so far, so we can't trigger our Phoenix Chicks to come back, but we're in a good spot. Even if they play Sheoldred here, they get land Sheoldred, I'm fine with that. Yeah, the following turn I'll have the extra Commandos. We're just attacking with this adversary here. So we can go land, adversary gets two counters on it, and we've got the two mana for the Phoenix Chick. So if they don't kill something before we attack, no, they're getting, yep. That's fine. They can't kill the Bloodthirsty Adversary unless they've got an Infernal Grasp, and they pay two for that, so that's, yep, there it is. Cost him one from the meat hook. That's fine. So next turn, we've got these two attacking. And Phoenixes in the graveyard. Yeah. Good luck to you. Yep, they're dead. See? You can get them down low enough before Sheoldred comes down. They did miss a land drop here or there, but just applying that pressure. Just pressure, pressure, pressure. Alright. This is a nice end. Turn on Kamano, turn two Kessig, then we can burn straight up if we want. Or we can get aggressive. But yeah, Kamano into Kessig stops it, and they're playing black, stops it from dying to cut down. We are on the draw though. On the play, it is much nicer. So if they hit turn four, Sheoldred. Black, white. Okay, interesting. So we may lose this Kessig to a cut down or similar. Ah, sorry, Infernal Grasp is the one I was thinking of. The two mana. It's not the end of the world because they pay two for it anyway. 465. Yeah, that's for one season. They've committed to five seasons, and it is billions of dollars. Alright, so we're just Storm Seeking here. Again, we're probably going to lose this dude. But we're just applying some pressure. Yep, cut down. It's now nighttime, so this dude's no longer a 2-3. This thing comes in on the night side, so doesn't die to cut down anymore. Let's spread the love. No, we want to give this thing haste, don't we? A Polyp TV rating. Welcome, everybody. Joining to watch us bash face with Mono Red. Welcome to the stream. We are the Magic Beans. Well, I'm one of the Magic Beans. And we've been punching people in the face all night with Mono Red, so stick around, enjoy, give us a follow while you're here. G'day Dan. There's too many ANs in there. Dan and Ada 123. Welcome. Yeah, okay, apparently enough. Yeah, we'll keep this. We'll go turn on Phoenix Chick, drop these two on turn two, hope to hit our third land. We're on the draw. We've had a pretty good run. Okay, Mono Blue again. Maybe. Hello, opponent. Always be nice to your opponents. Yep. Get used to all your things being bounced. Alright, we hit our third land, so that's nice. So we'll play the other Phoenix Chick. I've got some sort of response. Play the other Phoenix Chick. If they counter, I don't mind too much. Okay, Impulse, that's fine. From Spain, very cool. Not often we get Europeans joining us. The time zones, well, you kind of want the opposite time zone to us, so you left. Okay, cool. Well, welcome to the stream, Martinez. We do have some hamburger who's there in the chat. He's from Northern Ireland. We've got a few Americans. Okay, so we've got the blue-white tempo deck, so we're going to kill this thing before this gets out of hand. So we'll just burn it in a fire while they're tapped out, and we'll play our Ronin, get him for the extra damage. Just put that pressure on. I have no idea what you're saying. That looks Spanish. Hamburger is from... You're from the Philippines originally, aren't you, Hamburger? What did our opponent do there? Security bypass. Can't be blocked. When it deals combat damage to a player, it cannot. Okay, so it's a two-mana version. They're unlikely to be wanting to block. So we can Chandra. Plus gives us two mana. We can burn this thing. We just get super aggressive. I think we do that. While they're tapped out. Give yourself haste, Reckless Stormseeker. Bash them in the face. All right, they chose to block. Okay, do we hit plat two? Yeah, they just don't have enough lore. Yep, yeah, we just race. When we're in that position, we just race. Hey, platinum two. It's been a long time since I've been in platinum tier two. Ooh, okay, we haven't had a one lander yet tonight. We're on the draw, and we have a play with fire, which gives us scry. So I think we can actually keep this. We're at a 59% win rate tonight. It's not bad. I will keep this. Ooh, we've got Phyrexian Swamps. Okay, we hit the land. We can kill this thing. We do have the Kumano into Kessig play. And we do have removal for this thing unless they pump a ton of mana into it. So I think we've got the time to... I think we've got the time to kill this thing if we need to. This card is quite strong, actually. The old Figure of Destiny, one of my all-time favorite cards. Some would say it is literally my invitational card. Little short Kithkin dude. Didn't know you could get them. Why is that? That's weird. It shows up on here with funky writing, but not when you actually look at it. So holding up a single black. So this may be they've got cut down, and fortunately for them, the cut down is not going to work. Yeah, it looks like the jumpstart set symbol. Yeah, they've got cut down in hand. It's giving them priority because they can cut down their own evolved sleeper, but you can't cut down my Kessig Flame Breather. Sorry. Yep, so it's a 3-3 with Death Touch, that's fine. You can kill that with a Lightning Strike. Alright, so they're going to have a target with my Etching. I would really like to be Reckless Impulsing here to find some land, but I think we would just want to get this Sleeper off the field. Ping for one with Kessig. Yeah, that's true, Hemsy. Yeah, even though it's been leveled up, so to speak, it does always give them the option. And, yeah, looks like that probably was it. Got another one, so we can make that die in a fire. Another land is nice. I think we go Chandra here. Plus, and then play with fire, kill the Evolved Sleeper. See, look at that. Triggers, just pings extra damage. Chandra pings for an extra one. All just adds up. Kill this thing. Ping for another one. Bash for four. Like turn three, we have them on seven. On the draw. Alright, so Sauron's gonna make a vampire and we're just going to kill it. And then they're just dead. So we can have access to 4 mana. So we kill this thing, that pings for 1. We go to 6. That. Yeah, okay, they're dead in a bunch of different ways. Plus, shoot you. Lightning strike. Kill that thing. You're on 5. We can Reckless Impulse for an extra 1. We can Phoenix Chick for 1. It really doesn't matter. That's just Reckless Impulse. You dead. Okay, we're on the draw. We got 1 drops. I'm yet to play this in best of 3 though, so who knows how we go in best of 3. We're keeping this. Drawing a Kamano would be nice. Ooh, okay, so this is probably the green white thing. So do we need to kill that? Probably don't need to kill this just yet. So I think we play the Phoenix Chick. Even if they were to play 2 enchantments, still a 3-3 which we can kill. But I'd rather keep my removal up to kill the Jukai. The green-white enchantments deck is still pretty solid. Spirit of Companion, don't care too much about that. It's now more enchantments / spirits. Okay, so I think with the amount of burn we've got in our hand, we want to get this Kessig Flame Breather on the field. They could make this thing a little bit big next turn. But it is just the ground, dude, so some call inner professional would be handy. Alright, get a 1 mana enchantment. No, okay, so we're not blocking. Okay, land is nice, so question is, what are they playing in terms of protection spells? What do we have in standard 1 mana? They've got green or white. There is something. Maybe we attack with the Flame Breather as well and just see. Did I want to get tricky with a Spirited Companion? Tamiyo is safekeeping. Yeah, so I'm probably going to fire this off now because Tamiyo is safekeeping. Gives it +1/+1 and hexproof or something like that. So I'd rather do that in my turn. Okay, no, I got nothing. Cool. Get rid of that. We've got Play with Fire, so if they do play Jukai Naturalist, we can kill that thing. Hallowed Haunting. Yep. Got it. So I guess the question here is, do we want to... I don't care about killing these Spirited Companions. It's more, do we want the Scry? I think we do. Let's just try and get them dead quickly. Ooh, another Play with Fire is nice. Because then we can hold up Lightning Strike and Play with Fire. Yeah, I think we want to do that. Save these two dudes to just come down out of nowhere and just keep their board clear. No shortage of lands. Yeah, get a 1/1. Ew, Circle of Confinement. Now that's going to take out my Kessig. Excuse me. Alright, so... I think we just go face here. Let's... We're going to pile up the damage. I'm going to bottom that. Don't think that's what I want. Yeah, down to 3. We've got one coming across in the air. Kamanu's an extra 1. Reckless can pump the Phoenix as well. Just need to make sure they don't come out with lifelink. None of this is giving lifelink. This is only on one counter. Actually, I should have played the Kamanu, I reckon, there. So we could play this as a bigger dude next turn. Okay, well, this thing's got lifelink. But it doesn't have haste. Doesn't give the other dudes haste. We're just not blocking here. These things don't have lifelink. Yeah, and we just kill them with Kamanu. Or a play with fire. That works. Okay. We got there. That's going to do us for tonight. So, yeah. Mono Red has been fun. But yeah, that's going to do it for me tonight. Shout out again to these guys over here, Josh Pats, MTG Bazaar. Go and check them out. You'll see the link pops up every now and then on the bottom. jpmtgbazaar.com.au. They sponsor our tournament series and all the different things that we do. They are a Facebook auction group, so go there and check them out and bid on some auctions, get yourself some bargains on physical magic cards, and let them know the beans sent you when you do. And that's going to be it for me. So thanks for hanging out. Enjoy the outro video. See you all next time. Bye.